We get to meet ITC's new sUAS public safety instructor, Adam Ringle, in this week's IR Spectrum. We'll have that interview here in a moment, but first, a quick update from the Infrared Training Center. We've got you covered from the air with sUAS thermal imaging classes available from ITC. Whether using aerial infrared for inspections or public safety, ITC has the right certification class for you. Head to infradtraining.com/schedule for more information on our sUAS Level 1 thermography or Level 1 public safety courses, including upcoming dates and locations. We hope to see you there. Recently, I had the chance to work with Adam Ringle of Adam Ringle Consulting. He's a public safety professional with 30 years of experience who provides drone training to fire and law enforcement agencies. Adam stopped by our Boston Regional Training Center here to co-present a live webinar with DJI on how sUAS is being used in the public safety realm. After the webcast, we had the chance to chat about his work and how public safety agencies are using aerial thermal imaging. Here's what he had to say.
My background started in fire and EMS. I've been doing fire EMS law enforcement for about 30 years. The last 23 years I've been focused primarily on law enforcement, and I currently am in charge of forensics, and I run several drone programs for a few different law enforcement agencies. What I do for Adam Ringle Consulting is we do a lot of training related activities. We're training partners with doing some FLIR and ITC training for thermal. We do contract flight training. We do contract flights. We do commercial and residential property inspections, and we use thermal imaging for a lot of those inspection work. We use thermal imaging in public safety to track lost people, look for suspects, do apprehensions. We can search things from rooftops, properties for contraband, discarded weapons during a foot chase, those types of things. And it makes it significantly easier because some of the places that we work are very tight urban environments, and the helicopter's camera can't get low enough to see between tight alleyways and spaces that we can easily get the drone into. The unique challenges we encounter, a lot of they're twofold. A lot of them come from environmental factors such as urban environment, tight spaces, magnetic interference, those types of things. Understanding the relationship of how solar loading and having a delta T affect what you're going to see on the thermal imaging. And then the secondary challenge is utilizing the thermal imaging and getting that that material properly gathered for court purposes, understanding what high gain and low gain means in the camera settings, understand what the best way to potentially capture imaging in either high solar loaded areas or managing your AGL and managing your camera look down angle to compensate for those things so you can attempt to get your best thermal imaging in the minimum number of passes when either lives or seconds or something burning to the ground is all at stake. Yeah, absolutely. The advice I would give someone looking to add thermal imaging to their capabilities or get training prior to buying the sensor. It makes, it'll help you make less mistakes. It'll help you understand better what you're seeing and the imaging and the capabilities of the camera on a UAS platform. They're very different than handheld sensors, and a lot of the fire service guys that are used to using ticks for handheld, it's not necessarily the same thing when you throw it on a drone. The imaging may be the same, but the way you obtain the imaging is critically important. So I would definitely say training before buying the sensor.
By the way, if you're looking for that webinar we hosted with Adam and DJI, head to infradtraining.com/webinars. There you'll find drone fundamentals for public safety, as well as about 24 other topics available on demand and free for viewing at any time. Looking for more? Well, besides our sUAS training classes and webinars, we have an sUAS thermography group on Facebook that you're welcome to check out. You'll find it listed under groups where you can join and start participating in the community. Of course, we're also on Twitter, YouTube, Instagram, and LinkedIn, where we post industry news, special training offers, and a whole lot more. If you're looking to get certified, head to infradtraining.com/schedule for upcoming dates and locations in the US and Canada. And for thermographers based in Europe, the Middle East, or Africa, irtraining.eu is where you'll find a list of classes in your region. And if you've already registered for a class, we look forward to working with you. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you online again soon.